Oh yeah, boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen, what is not happening? If you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, make sure you do. Turn that notification bell icon on so that whenever I post a new story, you don't miss it. Actually, subscribing is the only way right now you can support me with. Please do it. Make sure we reach 10,000 subscribers as soon as possible. Now, better part of last week and still this week, what's trending in East Africa is Harmonize's new hit featuring H-Baba and Congolese superstar Awilo Longomba. Everything and the control. Controversies surrounding the music include allegations of Harmonize buying views on YouTube to make his single Break record, earlier said by Diamond's song Wah featuring Koffi Olomide, equally a legend from Congo like Awilo Longomba. Harmonize managed to hit 1 million views within 24 hours and 4 million views within 4 days of release of his song dubbed Attitude, in which he featured Awilo Longomba and Tanzanian H-Baba. Till now, the pace of increase of views seemed to have slowed down for Harmonize. I'm not gonna dwell on that. I'm not gonna discuss the beef between Harmonize and Diamond or Fosafi Record. Neither am I gonna discuss their efforts to outdo each other when it comes to who gets more views on YouTube. I'm gonna focus on what is trending in Kenya right now in regards to Tanzanian music getting too many views on YouTube, way too many than what Kenyan artists can get. And fans have been asking, why is it that Kenyan artists are not garnering massive views like their TZ counterparts? And it seems some artists have a clue about it. A section of them led by DJ Shitty say Kenyan audience is more diverse than that in Tanzania, explaining that Kenyan fans are more focused on other matters affecting lives such as politics, economy, health and whatnot, while Tanzanian audience is more inclined to entertainment news. I quote what he wrote on Instagram: mziki ya Kenya ni mziki inaishi for long, wewe sio zao za 2 weeks na kiki, alafu audience ya Kenya ni wajanja na wako busy. So kama ni artist ukifika 100,000 subscribers, shukuru. Again, Kenya online watu wa na focus na everything productive from politics, economic matters, etc. TZ ni entertainment pekee, so heshimu wasanii wetu. Hey, Shitty saying Kenyan music, and I'm gonna agree with Shitty on this. If you listen to Kenyan music, especially, I'm gonna use an example of Sauti Sol. Their music can be listened to now, tomorrow, the day after tomorrow, and it doesn't get old. But look at Tanzanian music. A lot of them are pushed using controversies. Recently we saw Harmonize trending after his scandal with his girlfriend, and maybe, I'm just saying maybe, his song garnered massive support because he's been trending for the better part of the month. And kiukweli, Kenyans focus on other things, especially politics. Kenyans focus on politics. Look at political channels on YouTube. They are doing so well because Kenyans eat politics, wake up politics, sleep politics, they die in politics. And following DJ Shitty's sentiment came to his support, rapper Naughty Flow and singer Willy Paul. Actually, Naughty Flow didn't quite support him, but she shed some light on how some Kenyan artists behave. You might think wamefaulu sana, she said, and I quote, na vile huwa wanaringa kupeana collab as if they've made it. They don't know umoja ni nguvu. TZ na Nigeria will keep leading musically if we don't wake up. She's calling for unity in Kenya. Some artists think they are bigger than others, yet hawajafikia levels za kina Harmonize when it comes to commanding numbers. Tuseme tu kweli tafadhali. Willy Paul on his side says Kenyans should not put pressure on artists, especially those they don't support, and he wants artists from comparing themselves to Tanzanian counterparts leading them to buying views on YouTube. Remember that Calligraph and Dr. Pizzo scandal of buying views on YouTube? Link to those stories I did are in our description below. Don't shy from checking out. Willy Paul says fans should not make fun of their own. By that he means our own artists, even if they are not able to get millions of views on YouTube. And he says wanaokudharau siku moja watakusalimia kwa heshima. I guess he means a country's music industry being famous is just a passing wave. At some point, Congolese music was leading, South Africa came, Niger came to stay, and here now Tanzania also claimed their space in East Africa. Posis optimistic that Kenyan music industry will have its place on the continental map someday. Do you think we will? I don't know. Just drop your comment on the comment section. DJ Shitty is the most furious here. He blames the failure of the Kenyan music industry to top musicians who, instead of supporting each other, they diss each other, and he openly blames them for slowing down Gengeton wave alongside COVID-19. So hata kama ni COVID-19 li affect Gengeton, the veteran rappers and singers have played part in dragging Gengeton down. But Shitty now promised Gengeton itarudi after he pandemic. All this he said in response to Octopizzo dissing Calligraph for using the pandemic as opportunity to get chums from Deputy President William Ruto. Hey man, you think Kenyans should get mad because Tanzania is doing well in music? I think so far those guys are working harder in terms of packaging and marketing, which Kenyans need to learn from them. I'll see you. Drop your comment on the comment section, uniambie if we're justified getting mad because Tanzanian artists are doing well. I'm your storyteller George Misati. Mimi pia hapa hivi, kazi yangu ni news, eh? Kazi yangu ni kukuletea magossip kila siku. So wewe kitu unaweza fanya tu kunisupport, sababu tumeambiwa tujisupport. Ehe, wewe fanya kunisupport, just subscribe to this channel, turn the notification bell icon on so that whenever I post a new one you don't miss it.